I haven't made a video in a while, and I really haven't done a video like this, so this is going to be something new. But it's going to be a sit-down video, and I'm basically going to be telling my running story, my D1 story. So it all started probably in about 5th grade or so. We have like this recess day where we get to get onto the track, and we basically be running laps around the track. I don't know why, but I always felt the need to run more than everybody, and so that's what I did. You know, someone had mentioned the idea of running cross-country to me, and so in 7th grade, I ran cross-country. 7th grade, ran cross-country. I definitely wasn't serious about it as I am now or anything like that, but I was just doing it for fun, and you know, I had fun. I had fun with the guys that I was running with and making memories and stuff like that. So in 7th grade in Ohio, when we'd run our cross-country meets, it'd be 2 miles. My first meet, which was on a fast course, was like 14:05 or something like that. So it wasn't a very impressive time. Yeah, I'm recording a YouTube video right now, though. You want to say hi to the YouTuber?
What's up?
So that was Ben. He's one of my teammates now. 7th grade, it got a lot better at the end of the year. I was definitely running faster. I ended up running, I believe, 12:33 last meet. I got second place, which was really huge to me. I didn't think that I was going to do something like that. So then 8th grade year, I thought I was going to be big and tough and play football. I wanted to play football all through middle school, but I wasn't able to because I had concussions and my parents wouldn't let me. This year, they decided to let me. And so in 8th grade, I played football. As you can see, it did not turn out that I was going to be a star football player. Ran track again. I ran track in 7th grade too, but that was not an impressive year, and I don't really remember anything from that year. In 8th grade track, though, I was definitely running distance. Farthest distance we ran was 1600, and I had a very impressive 6-minute flat 1600 at the end of the season. I actually was not able to participate in our invitationals. He only took the top 2 runners in each event in invitational, and I was the number 3 guy for that in middle school, so I was not that fast, and you know, it kind of hurt my dreams a little bit of running. Then freshman year, I decided to go back to cross country, and I would say I had a pretty good freshman year. Freshman year, I started off high 19s. So continued running freshman year, got down to the end of the season. My team, we were a very good team. We were competing at the district, and we were looking to win districts. I was on the top 7, which the top 7 got to compete at the district meet. And I was the 6th runner that day, and it came down to a tie for the championship. We tied for first place, and so I was the tiebreaker to help us win districts. And I ended, it was that meet, 18:02 as my freshman PR. On the sophomore season, right about the same fitness. I hadn't gotten that much faster. I was running most courses faster than I was the year before, but just not like tremendously faster. I got down to 17:45. I ran 18:05 at the district meet, which I was pretty disappointed about. So sophomore year, and the sophomore year is when I really became kind of serious about running. I competed at some track meets. We had very good seniors at that time that they ran the invitationals. So junior year was the really big year for running for me. I was definitely applying myself a lot more. I strained my hamstring during track season my sophomore year, but continued over into cross country as well, which was honestly just because of poor stretching and just the little things I needed to be doing for running. And I wish I would have known that at that time. I did not until I started going to physical therapy. So junior year, I missed out on a few meets, which I was definitely disappointed in. But I did help my team win one of our conference meets. And so my junior year, my PR got down to 17:27, I believe, or 17:28, one of the two. Which, you know, I was excited about, but I had really been hoping for a better year. I missed probably 4 or 5 meets that year, so. But then I went to physical therapy, got my hamstring figured out, and realized I just needed to stretch more, do the little things more. And that carried over into track season my junior year. Track, not my forte. So I did run track. Didn't run the greatest. I believe I ran 10:48 in the 2 mile. Going into my senior season, this is when the whole college aspect started coming into play. And you know, I loved running. I wanted to run in college. So what I had done is I'd gone on a website where you can receive like college information from different colleges that would be interested in you or interested in having you, that type of thing. Like this info cards that you get in the mail that like everyone hates. So I signed up for that and I literally went down and clicked every single school. I didn't care where the school was or what the school's name was, what division they were, I just clicked every single school. So after a few weeks I started receiving some of these info cards in the mail. Started looking through, looking at all these colleges, seeing if they had my major. I had originally intended on majoring in criminal justice. I pretty much ruled out Division III schools. I wasn't that interested in Division III schools, because I couldn't get a scholarship, and I don't know, I personally wanted to go Division II or Division I. So I started reaching out to a lot of colleges and hearing back from some coaches. I would say I reached out to, I think I counted the other day, and it was about 54 total colleges that had my major and that I was interested in running at. Probably only heard back from about 20, 25. Probably about 10 of those or so said, hey, like, your times don't meet what we're looking for, so we're not going to take you, pretty much. The summer into my senior year, I was training really, really well. My peak mileage was up to 58.5 miles. Running high mileage in the summer, and I was getting some good workouts in and everything. So season started, had very good success. Won my first meet in 17:29. This was a very big confidence boost for me. I won that. The next meet, I think I got like fourth place. It was a really big invitational as well. Then we had our home invitational. I believe I ran 17:33. Won that, which was a very big confidence boost as well. And then went on to win the Buckeye, which is one of our conference meets. I believe I won that in 17:24. So my times were right around mid 17, so they were not dropping. I wanted to be at 17 or under already, but that was just not gonna happen exactly. Also at this time, I was still talking to colleges, trying to figure out where I wanted to go. Took a visit to St. Anselm College, which is in New Hampshire. So I originally intended to go to the school, Division II school, private. It was very expensive though, which was gonna be the only thing that threw me off. Basically, just the things did not work out financially and with scholarships and stuff, and things just did not work out in my favor for that. Ran at our big conference meet, which I got 8th overall out of a little over 250 maybe. There might have been about 200. Very big meet. I won my class, which was very good, and I believe I went 17:30. It was a very tough course. Conditions were awful, very muddy. Then throughout the year, I won Belmont County invite, which wasn't a huge meet. It was very hilly course, very muddy. I think I ran maybe low 18s or just sub 18 there, which is pretty impressive for how hilly of a course it is. Third at another invite. Very good runner was there, Chase Stewart. He's running at Youngstown State. He won that meet. And at the end of the year, we have a meet called OVCCO, Ohio Valley Cross Country League. I got second to him there. And so it was at the end of the year, very cold, but I kind of thrive in that weather, I would say. I ran 17:04. That was my PR. And I still don't even think that I had a good race, but it was a very good time. I really wanted to go sub 17. It just didn't work out for me. So at this point, I had played basketball freshman through junior year in high school, and my senior year came around and I just decided it's time to really focus on what I'm good at and drop this dream of becoming a professional basketball player. I was running in the winter. I was training pretty well, maybe about 40 miles a week, nothing too major, just trying to build a base for track. So at this time in the winter, coming off of cross country season, I was talking to a coach from St. Francis University. It's in central Pennsylvania. It was a Division I school, which was very exciting to me, the fact that it was a Division I school wanting me to run for them. So I took an official visit. I really liked it and really liked what they had to offer. Fast forward into track, I had an okay track season. I was running right about the times I was my junior year. I think I went 10:49 in the 2 mile. I just never had a good race, never to what I should have been able to run. In the mile, I went 4:56. So during track season, I had committed to St. Francis University, and that's where I was going to go. Throughout the summer, everything was going well. I was training, planning to go to this Division I school. And then towards the end of the summer, some things started getting thrown into perspective. The debt that I would have had to pay off was very, very large. And also at this time, I had recently started a business. Can't say which business that is, because, you know, NCAA doesn't allow this, me to self-promote myself, you know, NCAA, pay your athletes, please. But they don't allow us to do this. So we'll just say I started this business. Definitely was seeing a future with this. So then my decision, I was questioning even more, and then I had come to the decision that St. Francis would just not be right for me. It was too far away from where I was. I wouldn't be able to maintain my business with my partner locally. And then the price was just very expensive as well. So nothing against the school, great school. Love the coach, was very nice. Guys on the team were awesome, but it just was not in my future for me. Then with about 3 weeks left until most fall semesters would start, scrambling a little bit, and I had taken a visit to Wheeling Jesuit University back in February, but this was after I'd already visited St. Francis and I wasn't really considering it as much then. So I reached out to the coach again, and luckily I was able to come here, and this is where I'm at today, Wheeling University, running Division II. So you will see a lot of videos from Wheeling University and everything there. That's where my story ends as of right now. It's going to continue, I hope, for the next 4 years at least for running, maybe even more after that. But if you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. If you're new, go check out my channel, subscribe. I have some more running content on here. And so there will be a lot more videos to come from just this one. I'm planning on making a lot more content, especially through college. And
I hope you stay afloat. Stay afloat, no, make 'em crazy. You better watch your hoe.